we are going to talk about the four voyages of Christopher Colombo. First of all, we are going to talk a little bit about the life of this man. Christopher Columbus, known as the man who discovered America. Columbus was in fact trying to find a western world sea passage to the ocean when he landed in the New World in 1492. This unintentional discovery was to change the course of world history. Christopher Columbus was born in Genoa between August and October 1451. Christopher went to sea, traveled extensively, and eventually made Portugal his base. It was here that he initially attempted to gain royal benefits for a westernward voyage to the Orient, his enterprise of the Indians. When this failed, and appealed to the French and English courts, were also rejected. Columbus found himself in Spain, still struggling to win backing for his project. Finally, King Fernando and Queen Isabella agreed to a sponsor the expedition. This map shows a different place where Christopher Columbus arrived. First voyage. On the evening of 3 August 1492, Columbus departed from Palos de la Frontera with three ships, La Niña, La Pinta, and La Santa Maria. They were property of Juan de la Cosa and the Pinson brothers, but managed to support the Palos and inhabitants to contribute to the expedition. Columbus first sailed to the Canary Islands, which were owned by Catalan, who sought the provisions to make the first. On 6 September, he departed from San Sebastian de La Gomera for what he turned out to be a 5-week voyage across the ocean. The land was sighted at 2 a.m. on October 1492. By a sailor named Rodrigo de Piana, who aboarded him. Columbus called the island San Salvador, in what is now the Bahamas. The natives called it Guanahani. The indigenous people were peaceful and friendly with Columbus and his men. Columbus also explored the northeast coast of Cuba in the north coast of Hispaniola by 5 December. Here the Santa Maria ran aground on Christmas morning 1492 and had to be abandoned. It was received by the native Cacique Huacanayari, who gave him permission to leave some of his men behind. Columbus left 39 men and founded the settlement of Navidad in what is now present-day Haiti. Before returning to Spain, Columbus also kidnapped some 10 to 25 natives and took them back with him. Only 7 and 8 of the Native Indians arrived in Spain alive, but they made quite an impression of the deal.
Second voyage. On a second large expedition, September 25, 1493, June 11, 1496, Columbus sailed with 70 ships and 1,500 men to find gold and capture Indian as a slave in the Indians. He established a base in Hispaniola and sailed around Hispaniola and along the land of Sur Cuba. He spotted and named the island of Dominica on November 3, 1493. third voyage. On a third voyage expedition, May 30, 1498, on October 15, Columbus sailed farther south to Trinidad in Venezuela. Columbus was less first European since the Viking less frequent to sail foot on the mainland of America. Fourth voyage. On his fourth, the last expedition, May 9, 1502, November 7, Columbus sailed to Mexico, Honduras, and Panama. In Central America, in Santiago, Jamaica, Columbus is a British in Eastern Hispaniola, now called the Dominican Republic.
The established America. After Columbus found North America, many people, especially the merchants who had lived in Europe, transported to North America and lived there for the need of trade. Some hundred years later, people lived there united to fight with their original nation for freedom and had won the last victory. Then, the United States had been established. Columbus had found Bahamas, Cuba, and North America. His activity has deeply proposed the development of the communication of various countries and the technique of sailing in the West world, especially the countries like Spain, England, has become the most powerful country quickly through trading outside.
These activities of Columbus have directly proposed the expanding of West world. Not only Christopher Columbus, Vasco da Gama has come to India, and Fernando Magallanes has traveled around the world for the first time in the human history. These activities contribute a lot to the development of trading all over the world. Memory Columbus. In homage to Columbus and his voyages to discover the American, Madrid has erected two monuments in the Alfonso Martinez district in an area that became known as Plaza Colón. Columbus statue. Columbus himself stands next to the three monuments for ships in the pinnacle of a tall column and facing eastward toward the open sea. Columbus Monument, the second monument to Columbus, is a large charging cement piece that look at it like an anchor.
Columbus Day. Columbus Day is celebrated in the USA on the second Monday in October. It is a day in which Americans celebrate Christopher Columbus' voyage from Spain to Hispaniola, North America in 1492. That, in fact, to celebrate or not to celebrate Columbus Day is a topic to debate all around the world. Many historians think that Columbus has found a way of escape from all world tyranny. He was the solitary individual who changed that in our sea, as trying America contemplate the dangers and promise of their own wilderness frontier.
Controversy. Also, traditional historians view Columbus' voyages as opening the new world to Western civilization in Christianity. Many historians view him as a villain, and they believe his discoveries made the beginning of the destruction of Native American people and culture. In recent years, many people who view Columbus Day as a celebration of conquest in Geneva have rejected his holiday and replaced it with Indigenous People Day.